opportunity to speak on this important bill, Central Universities Amendment Bill 2019, further to amendment the Central University Act 2009. Sir, as far as this bill is concerned, very important bill we are going to discuss in this August session. Sir, the bill seeks to amend Central University Act 2009, established two central universities in Andhra Pradesh. Apart from Goa, Andhra Pradesh, only state India which does not have a central university. The establishment of Central University Andhra Pradesh is mandatory under the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization 2014. The bill states that the objective of establishing of two universities to increase access and quality of higher education and facilitate the promote avenues higher education and research facilities for the people of state of Andhra Pradesh. Sir, in this bill there is no specific issues mentioned here. One is unclear statement of objects and reasons. Second one, no detailed mention of funding of the universities.
You don't have it in the bill. Detailed funding is never done in the bill.
Yeah. Ensuring quality education and the reducing funding in central universities remain a big issue. These are the main important lackness in this bill. Sir, establishing new central universities, the government wants to promote the higher education in all the part of the country, especially backward areas also. The bill does not give details of establishing two universities. It is only state that the aim would be to enhance education and research in two universities. For example, there is no mention in the bill about the curriculum and administration of the university. Sir, similarly the tribal university. For the tribal university, it is unclear whether the university would be reserved for tribals especially. And what percentage of tribal population would be university benefit? In what way the university would promote advanced knowledge by providing institutional and research facilities in tribal art, culture and custom and advancement in technology to the tribal population of India? It is also unclear. The bill is missing on the crucial details of the separate curriculum of the university. The BJP government, NDA government, is known to reduce funding in central universities. Besides, the BJP government has also unduly interfered with the administration of many of the public universities in India. There has been an attempt to reformulate the curriculum to these universities. Besides, the central universities in India are vastly under affected. As of July 2018, a total of 12 central universities out of 40 have more than 75% vacancies of professors, while for two of the universities the vacancy is 100%. For example, Central University of Haryana and Odisha have 10% vacancy of process are not filled. Sir, I'm going to give some examples, sir. In Odisha, it is one of the 15 central universities established by UPA government during UGC 11th plan period to address the concerns of equity and access, and as per the policy of the government of India to increase No, you can, whenever your turn will come, you can say that. Sir, what is the position in Odisha University? I will give you the example. Sir, number of sanctioned posts, teaching posts I am coming down. Sir, I am not going to all the universities. I am only giving the Odisha University, Central University. Teaching staff, professors, sanctioned staff is 23, posted nil.
That was the position of 1st April 2018.
Yes. And...
It's in Koraput.
Yes. So, these are details according to various fora available in the library also, sir. Associate post is 43 posts. One only posted. 42 lying vacant. And also assistant professor 88. 16 posted, 72 is lying vacant. This is the situation in Odisha Central University. Not only in Odisha University, Central University.
No, this is the reply I think the former minister in last Lok Sabha had given in this house.
Yeah.
Mr. Javadekar, when he was Minister HRD, he had given this answer in this house.
Still the situation is going on. There is no change. No appointment has been done so far. So while moving the amendment, the Central University of Kerala, in my state also I have to point out some motives. Sir, the serious lapses that the government in conveniently silencing higher education is the key and gateway to the nation's progress. The allocation for higher education needs to be parallel with the increase in gross enrollment ratio. As per the All India Survey on Higher Education 2017-18, gross enrollment ratio GR in higher education in India 25.8%, which is calculated for 18-23 age group. So in 2016-17, the GR was 25.2% based on the increase ratio. I reiterate the position of Kothari Commission that 6% of GDP must be allocated for the education sector. The fact, however, remains that the share of education spending the total union budget has decreased from 4.6% 2014-15 to 3.5% entry budget 2019-20. The spending on education sector as a percent of GDP has reduced under the NDA government in the past 5 years. The Ministry of Education, renamed as Ministry of Human Resource Development, failed to spend over rupees 4 lakh crore made available to them between 2014-15 and 2018-19, failing to meet budgetary targets. According to a Center for Monitoring Indian Economy report, the underspending by the NDA government was nearly 17% in 2014-15, which was highest in the last 10 years. Sir, the central universities, we have to ensure the quality of the education. In Kerala also, central university in Kerala is established in Kasaragod. It's a very backward district. So in that central university also, Kerala Central University also, facing serious problem for the posting of the teachers. Still, number of vacancies are vacant there. So our ministry has not taken into serious to fulfill the teachers' vacancy. Sir, without teachers, without professors, associate professors and assistant professors, how can run the university, sir?
Your point is taken. You have another member from your party to speak.
Yes, I am concluding, sir. I am not going into details. Sir, in Central University in Kerala, the BJP has promised not only BJP leaders, even ministers also promised when they came to Kerala, they are going to rename for Central University Narayana Guru. This was their promise. But so far no action has been taken. So I would like to request Honorable Minister to rename the Central University of Kasaragod for Sri Narayana Guru Devan. You know, Honorable President of India, in his speech, he mentioned about Sri Narayana Guru Devan. So if we are honored, our honor to Sri Narayana Guru Devan, then you have to give renaming of the Sri Narayana. So another important social reformer, Sri Ayyangali is the great social reformer in Kerala. The UPA government period, one Ayyangali chair was established in Kasaragod Central University. After that, the NDA government came to power. This chair was cancelled. So I would like to request Honorable Minister to reinstate that chair and sanction sufficient fund for
this chair. Thank you, Mr. Suresh.
This chair.
Your point is
to
take.
Know the students who is
Mr. Rajiv Pratap Puri,
who is great social former Sri Ayyangali. Sir, in my constituency there is one Raja Ravi Verma Arts School. So that school can take over by Central University.
It's your demand.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Yes, Mr. Rudy.